my beautiful people, hope you all are doing well. So we are back with another pep talk, and today we are going to talk about how positivity is related to productivity. So whenever we are feeling lazy, we don't do really anything throughout the day, and we just say to ourselves that today I'm feeling lazy, I'm not going to do anything, I'm just going to sit, lie down and just enjoy. And that's okay. It's actually good, in fact, if you spend one lazy day in about 2 weeks and, you know, just give your body the time to recharge. That's okay. That's good and that's healthy. But sometimes what happens is that one day becomes 2 days and then 3 days and then 4 days of laziness, and you just don't do anything productive. And what happens to this is, our energy gets low. When we are lazy, we don't feel energetic and we just keep laying down throughout the day, right? And when our energy is low, it automatically affects our mood. So you start getting irritated. And that's the first sign of negativity. So when you're irritated, you also start attracting negative energies instead of positive energies. While one day is actually healthy for us to let our body recharge, let all the stress out, and come back with the positivity and more energy, if that extends more than one day, it actually impacts us in a negative way. But I also know that not every day can be productive, not every day you can have tasks to achieve. So I'm going to share with you few things that I do when I don't have anything productive to do. The tips I'm going to give you may not be that productive, but they are definitely important. So one is self-care, obviously. That's what our series is about, self-care. I make DIY face mask and hair mask, and I do put efforts in it, which makes my mind to think that I'm being productive. And at the end of the day, it actually affects in a positive way. It makes my hair better, it makes my skin better. So even though it was unproductive, it was absolutely worth it also. You can do art and craft. If you're into painting, you can paint. If you're into making DIY things, you can do that. I love doing that a lot. So you can do that. If you're into music or if you're into dancing, just sing or play instrument or just dance on your favorite numbers, right? That's some exercise you're doing, which is also important. And what else? Cooking. So you can make anything that's your favorite. Just look up the recipe. Maybe I have posted the recipes. Check them out. I'll link few over here. So just whatever you like to eat or whatever your favorite dish, whatever you're craving at that moment, just go and cook it. So in a way, you are pleasing your own self, right? And yeah, so this way you can actually think a few more things. I may not have pinpointed them out. Do gardening, like for example, and that way they may not be that productive for you, but they definitely are very important for your inner health, for your mental health, because they do put a very positive impact on you and on your mind as well. So whatever makes you feel like, you know, whatever makes you feel good about yourself, do that activity. Don't be that lazy. Just get up and start doing it, and you'll find yourself actually getting involved in it and enjoying it. And it will definitely turn out to be a very helpful thing. May not be that productive, but it will keep your energy up, it will keep your positivity up, and it will keep you going. So I hope that you enjoyed this video, and I hope that you won't stay lazy that much, and you will use these tricks on your mind, and you will start doing something or the other when on the days you're not that productive, right? And So I'm going to meet you guys in the next pep talk. That's going to be my last one because it was a mini series and I'm just going for 4 videos and this is my 3rd. So I hope you are enjoying this series and stay focused, stay productive, stay positive. Until next time, namaste.